This allows you to select a number of different transforms to convert your circuit, and I'm going to look at just the lump transform. So for example, if I expand the Norton transforms and I click on series transform, it shows me that I can apply a Norton series transform to a part and come up with, this is the after transform schematic. Now, why would you want to start with one component and end up with three in a transformer? Well, that is one way to do a impedance transform at the output. The transformers will end up canceling. One of these components is negative and cancels out another, so you actually only ended up with one extra component. We also have a button that automatically applies this called Remove Transformer, and if I click on that, you notice it does the transform for us, and our final schematic has no transformer. So what we have is we have a perfect symmetrical response that we're looking for, and we have a schematic that if I expand it and zoom in on the schematic, you can see that the inductors are within the range or the min-max that we specified in the first tab. But we have an inductor that's about 298 nanohenries, another that's about 117, and then we have another one here, it's about 91. An ideal solution would be if we could make all of these inductors the same value, and then we would only have to procure one inductor value. Well, this is another application of the transforms that we show here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to perform a transform to convert all of the inductors to the same value. The History tab is the last tab and keeps track of all the transforms that were applied to the circuit. So we can show each action that we take to convert the circuit. And as you remember, this is the original circuit with the transformer that we started with. So if I apply a Norton shunt transform to the first inductor and then simplify the schematic, the first inductor and second inductor are now the same value. If I zoom in, you can see they're both 298 nanohenries. And what we do is perform the Norton series transform as we progress through the circuit until we get to the final design, which if we zoom in, you can see now that each of the inductors is the same value at 298 nanohenries. Now the final step is to set the capacitors to standard values. And the easiest way to do this is to select all of the capacitors in the circuit, as I'm doing here. Go up under the schematic pull down and say make tunable, and then they show up in our tune window on the left. If we set the variable to standard value, then you can set the tolerance to any tolerances you want. We'll set it to 1% so that we don't perturb the response too much. And then when you tune the capacitors, you can tune them slightly and they will set to standard values. So you can see that as we go through, we can set each of the capacitors to standard values and the response is not changed dramatically. So now we have the circuit with all of the inductors the same value, all of the capacitors are set to standard values, and we still have our symmetrical response both in S21 and in group delay.